What is up YouTube? Luca here. Look at this, guys. Oh yeah, the Goliath is back. The Bash Bomber, actually, is back. Let's get started. On the body, Clever Alchemist in heavy armor. It gives 675 weapon damage if we're in combat and we take a potion. As Monza said, what else? Balorg. Then Malakut to empower our bash attacks, one trainee, and on the back bar agility with one necklace, one shield in sturdy, and an axe in sharpened. On the front bar the Veteshrum perfected the great sword. As you can see on the glyphs, full bash damage glyphs in full infused. By the way, you could go with acuity on the back bar instead of agility if you don't have access to the Malakut ring. It's more or less the same DPS. Traits: 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 impen, 1 sturdy, and 2 well fitted. Full prismatic. Then, like I said before, full infused with bash damage glyph on the jewelry. Front bar Nirnholm with the Berserker glyph, and on the back bar a sharpened axe and a sturdy shield with the stamina drain poisons. Quick look on the skills: front bar executioner, then blast bones, dizzy swing, mortal coil, and rally as ultimate Dornbeck of smiting. On the back bar, caltrops for major breach, race against time for extra crit damage and movement speed, Resolving Vigor over here, Summoner's Armor or Resistance buff, and Spirit Guardian for 10% damage mitigation and an extra heal. And then the most important stuff, the Pummeling Goliath. Well, this thingy was completely broken when the Stamina Necromancer got released. For a couple of weeks you've seen a lot of Stormcrows bomb bashing enemies down with 15-20k bash hits, AoE bash hits. It got nerfed, of course, but it's still possible with the setup and it's still strong. You can still hit 8 to 10k plus bash, so pretty damn nice. You will see it in the gameplay footage that it's still possible to bomb with a Stamina Necromancer in Goliath with the bash attacks. As race, I'm Dunmob. Probably not the best race to go, but it's decent. It gives still weapon damage and max stamina stats. Orc should be better, offer more tankiness, a Nord or Imperial. As Wunderstone, the Lava for extra penetration, and the Lava Food Swoop as buff food. I put 20 points in health and 44 points in stamina. Potions: most of the time the resistance potions with physical resistance, stamina, and health. Quick look on the CPs: blue ones, Duelist Rebuff, Resilience, Master at Arms to increase our bash damage, which is direct damage, Biting Armor to empower our AoE bash attacks from the Goliath, and the red CPs: Rejuvenation, Slippery, Juggernaut, and Ironclad. Now you may ask me, Luca, why the fuck are you playing a Stamina Necromancer bash bomb build? Well, I'm out of ideas and I'm trying to, like I said in previous videos, I'm trying to find some unique builds or old builds just for some diversity in this game. It's always the same. There are 5-6 best in slot sets in PvP, also in PvE. Everyone is playing the meta, of course, why not? It's the best choice. But I'm trying to find some other sets, some unusual sets which are almost the same, which are not best in slot, but still enjoyable and still nice to play. If you want to bomb as, you know, the usual way, then check out my Magicka Nebel bomb build, I will link it down in the description below. Now enjoy some gameplay footage, most of those clips are in Battlegrounds. I made in Battlegrounds just because I don't have time at the moment to play in Syro, and if I have time, it's almost always prime time, and you know prime time is unplayable, laggy as hell, so enjoy the gameplay footage. You made a promise, I kept it. Now I'm second guessing. My whole world has shifted again. Now I drop back to an empty room, and it's setting in. Now that your things are gone. Here we are at the end of another PvP build video. Thanks for watching, have a nice day, and I'll see you hopefully in the next video.